Hey, what's up? I'm Tatum.
And I'm Nunu.
And you are now watching an all-new episode of
The Buzz. Yeah.
So today, on today's topic, we are going to talk about the transgendered community.
Right. We never really talk in depth about transgender community. They are considered as being a part of the LGBT.
Definitely.
But people, when people look at gay people, they don't know there's so much going on and so many different types of gay people. And transgender people is one of those people who always get overlooked on equality and other stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? So, shout out to Diamond Styles. I did an interview with Diamond Styles. She's a transgender woman. And I asked her anything out the book, even from like, do you still got your dick and everything. She blunt. She would let me know. So I did a good interview. So if you guys missed that, one-on-one interview is below.
Also, you know, we were discussing the topic of the transgendered child earlier.
Yeah.
There was a documentary on her. With Barbara Walters. Mm-hmm. Go ahead and give us some more insight in regards to that.
Yes, her name is Jasmine. And Barbara Walters did like an exclusive ABC interview.
Yes.
On that, and she was in depth, and the interview consists of like her everyday life and what the influence on the parents is for her to transgender, and what was the first signs of, hey, my child is transgender, and what steps did they make? Mm-hmm. They went in depth about like a lot of things, like
right.
Dating,
I mean,
for her. She's
11
years old and she started liking boys. So they did an interview of her, and she said, what would you tell your boy? What do you have? She said, I have a girl,
a female brain
and a boy's body. Yes.
Yes. And I did watch clips of the documentary with Barbara Walters, and I found it very interesting and intriguing. Partially really because I did watch an episode of Law and Order where the father, you know, was victimized. His balls and his penis were bashed in, but he had a daughter that was a boy and was transitioning, was about 11 years old, and it was really, really crazy. So, I mean, it's, you know, there are people out there that, you know, are feeling some type of way. Mm-hmm. Do you feel like, what's your opinion on these people? Like, what's your opinion on
I think is,
if you had a child, what I'm trying to really ask is, if you had a child and they were feeling this way,
it would be different because I'm gay. So,
okay.
Of course, me being gay, I'm more comfortable with it and I can understand it more. But Barbara Walters, you know, she was interviewing their parents, mother and father, and they are straight. So they was talking. I don't know. I can't answer your question. But what I know that, you know, parents is that parent right there is kind of iffy because they have two of them. So why you know, it's kind of iffy. Like, are they trying to get a reality show or what's going on?
Well, in all honesty, I really think the fact that they have done this documentary on this young girl, I really feel like she's going to be taunted, know, growing up, and it's really going to be, they're creating a hardship for her.
Exactly.
More than she would really have to experience if she were just to be living, you know, a regular life. Not saying there's nothing wrong with a hardship. Sometimes we have to go through things and endure
things.
This is a
little kid, you want them
but
to
I
grow
feel like,
and learn.
Right,
stuff
I feel like they're bringing this onto her a little bit.
But she can be a good activist. And for little kids, because there's a there was a poll and say there is an increase of transgender children. So it's like maybe she can encourage them to make sure be a spokes girl of, you know,
right. What I wanted to touch on is the fact that you said, oh, you know, you're gay, you know, so you might not have a problem with it. But in all honesty, I'm gay. I don't really know if I would want a daughter to want to be a man.
Right.
I don't know if I'm comfortable with that.
But you being gay, you should at least,
I mean, of course I'm gonna definitely let them embrace themselves, and I'm gonna
encourage it. You won't encourage it though.
I don't know.
Okay.
I don't know if I would necessarily be happy. Not saying that her parents are happy, I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know if I would be comfortable.
Yeah.
I think I'd be more comfortable having a gay child than a child that wants to live as a different sex.
Right. So
I don't know.
When you really think about it, transgender men and women face more like discrimination.
Of course, definitely. And I don't, that really has nothing to do with it. Maybe it's just my own personal feelings, and I don't discriminate against anybody, mm-hmm. clearly, but
They have to come out to their parents 2 times. Hey, I'm gay. 5 years later, hey, I'm transsexual. So it's like,
well, I mean, you know, a lot of times I think parents see these signs. I think parents see these signs growing up, you know, and mm-hmm. if they don't, then shame on them. And I think, you know, if that's the case, I think if you're a parent and you're seeing those signs, don't put yourself in denial. Face it. Mm-hmm. You know, so that way when your child is coming forward to you, mm-hmm. you might be more comfortable.
Most people are too worried about their self and what other people might say, okay. especially in the Black community.
Right.
It's like, you would not say hi and proud. You would just not accept them in your life, going to church or going to school, because they're transsexual or they're gay. So but it's like being a transsexual, you just exiled off the Black community. For me, it's like, wow, you just.
Well, we're stepping into a new generation, so really, they do have it hard. But I right. think, in all honesty, black gay women, black gay men, uh-huh. Black transgender. We all have it very, very hard, you know, no matter what. So I definitely think that parents, if you are seeing signs, don't jump to conclusions. Don't be so prejudiced.
The point.
Really just love your child.
What if they just like, it's so hard to figure out. This is a good point. It's so hard to figure out if your child is transgender when the parents always think that they're just gay. So probably went to the counselor.
That's when it comes to, right. I mean, that's when it comes down to, if you are seeing these signs in your child, feeling like maybe your child is gay, you aren't sure, you should probably start doing research.
That's the last thing people think about.
You should probably start doing research.
If they see gay tendencies of a child, that the last thing they're going to think about, oh, he must be transsexual. The most common thing they say gay, but I was trying to figure out how they really understood, hey, you know, this is this when.
Well, I have
you
friends.
You buy clothes for the child, you buy dresses for them. It's like you kind of influence them to not only be gay, but to go and continue on to be transsexual. Because some of these parents don't know the difference between gay people. They see what they see on TV. Like, you look at Housewives, and it said gay is a dress and stuff like that. So when they say my kid is gay, he must be transsexual, because look at this queen on TV wearing a dress. So they don't know. So I don't understand, how can you just say, hey, you're gay or you're just transsexual? Which one are you? So when you buy clothes for them, when you buy them dresses and stuff like that, you influence them to. Because they think that gay people wear dresses, and you make them wear a dress.
I mean, you know, sometimes, I don't know. I think that I get what you're saying. I think that parents, like I was saying, if you are seeing these signs in your child, not necessarily that they're going to be transgender, you don't necessarily know. But you could be like, okay, I feel like my son is gay, or he's very feminine, he's overtly feminine, mm-hmm. then you start doing your research on the community and seeing what resources you can find
and
for yourself,
when you go to a therapist,
for yourself to help cope with that, maybe ask questions. And then when your child gets older enough, you've already been preparing yourself as that good mm-hmm. parent to be able to, you know, communicate with your child, to maybe accept, you know, I don't know.
Right.
I definitely think that, you know, life is about planning. And life is about the unexpected as well. So you never know what's going to happen. So maybe you should just prepare yourself and plan for the unexpected.
Well, you guys should check out the whole interview. It's actually, the link is below. Barbara Walters. The little girl name is Jasmine. And check it out for yourself. Comment below. Let us know what you think about.
And it's very interesting too, because a child is so innocent. So, you know, for a child to really be feeling this way, one thing you can't take away from someone is how they're feeling, you know? So I would hope people would really not judge and would really look at this situation with an open mind, that this is a possibility and it can happen to anybody. and to maybe not be so discriminatory, maybe mm-hmm. look at an innocent being and really think, hey, but, you know,
and maybe
think about it. Think
about
it before
you discriminate. There are other ways to find out, like, as parents, if you feel like your child is, you don't know what they're, you know, transgender, want to be transgender, pre-op, of course, and gay. What they did on an interview, they brought her to a therapist, and she was talking to the therapist. I guess the therapist came to the conclusion, hey, you know, this is rare, but hey, your child is transgender. I don't know if that made them influence them, because there's so many ways, I don't know. Man.
I mean, you know, in all honesty, I get what you're saying. You're talking about being influential, and maybe the parents are influencing their child, but if you really think about that, I really need you to step back and think about yourself and what you were feeling as a child. Did you feel gay, or do you feel like it was influenced?
Mine was influenced.
Okay.
Mine, that's why I come from that place of, like, hey, something influenced it to go further. And parents have live a great place in these children's lives, and they influence.
See, I don't feel like mine was influenced. I think
it can be true. Just like they did on interview. Now she's ready. Like, she want boobies now. She tell them, Barbara, I want boobies. I want what the other girls have. So it's kind of like she don't know. She's clueless, and of course, you know, she's a beautiful little girl. She's
right.
Pretty.
She definitely, and that's what's so interesting too. Is you know, a lot of people are really suppressing these feelings about how they might want to be a different sex, and but at the end of the day, I've seen a lot of boys who look amazing as women, who look better than real women. So, you know, I don't know.
But some people
what
do
they're
it
feeling,
for,
like,
you know,
as far as me, I don't
work,
feel like
some people do it for a living.
So. I don't feel like being gay was, and I don't feel like it was influenced, right, or I was influenced by anything. I think that I was already feeling a certain type of way internally, right, and I was already attracted to certain things,
right,
you know, like, or like beauty, or like fashion, or like simple things like nails. So definitely look below for the link as far as the video is concerned with the interview with Barbara Walters and the transgender child.
Yeah.
This is going to conclude the episode of The Buzz with
Nunu and Tatum. Comment below, let us know what you think. Visit yourboynunu.com.
And follow me on Instagram, tatted_rockstar.
And your boy Nunu.
Right.
See you.
Time to change.
Comment and subscribe. For bios, pictures, and other shows with Nunu, visit yourboynunu.com. We'll be right back.